Now move like a monkey.
Here is the hand of the Lord, Jesus now. When
You put the oil in the pot and you let it get hot. You put the popcorn in it and you start to grin. Sizzle, 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 pop!
All right, down to the floor. Show me your toes. Point, flex. Uh-oh, Madeline got kicked out somehow. Point and flex. Point and flex. There she is. Arms gracefully.
job. Let's see how far you can reach. All right, put your sauce in. Let's go around in a circle. Around in a circle. Do you all feel a good stretch? Let's see, Ellie, make your legs match mine. Charlie, can you move that basketball hoop out of your way? I bet you have big enough muscles too. I bet you can. Scoot it out of your way so you have room to dance. All right, put your knees up.
Maybe. All right.
If you're not very strong, you can just stay here. You're just feeling like you're tired today. That is fine. We all have days like that. But if you're feeling super strong, go to level 2. Uh-oh, let's see who's feeling like a superhero today. Level 3.
Listen for my sound. And when you hear it, you're going to push up with strong arms and be a mermaid on a rock. Good stretch for our backs. Are you ready? Listen for my sound. Tweet, tweet, tweet. What is it? Is that a bird? Yeah. All right. Push up with those strong arms. Let me see your tail behind you. Oh my goodness. You have some long tails. I see them. Let's see, Charlie. Let me see your mermaid tail. Good, Harley. Oh, that's good. Clara's doing a back stretch already. Awesome. Let's do that after the next one. Here we go. Here's my fairy dust. Go to sleep. All right, let me think of another good sound. Oh, I have a really good one. Meow. I see Harley's cat there. That's why I did another little kitty cat sound. All right, this time bend your knees and see if you can touch your toes to your head. If somebody's in the room with you, they might want to give your chin a tickle if you're looking all the way up and your toes are reaching your bun. Put your little bottom down, Ellie. Put your bottom down. Bottom down. Take your popo down. Your popo's up. Stay down. Push it down, girlfriend. And all the way up. All right, curl your toes in and let's start downward dog. And walk your feet in your hands and roll it up. Good job. Okay, would you guys like to hear a story? I have a fun story for you. Okay, so we're going to be a little silly. Wait a second. You don't know how to be silly, do you? No. Okay, well, we're going to be a little bit silly, and we're going to act out a story, okay? And you might know this story, but I don't know if you do. Maybe you haven't acted it out before, maybe you have. It is called The Ugly Duckling. Do you know that story about the ugly duckling? No? Okay. Well, once upon a time, there was a mama duck, okay? And so she was a very happy mama duck, and she waddled around. So pretend you are the mama duck, and show me your wings. And she was going around the barnyard, and she waddles like this. Can you show me how a duck would waddle? Waddle, waddle, waddle. And what does a duck say? Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack. Oh, good, I see it. Harley's wiggling her hair, there you are. Okay, so one day, that mama duck, she laid 6 eggs. Can you believe it? She had 6 babies in those eggs. And one by one, those eggs hatched. Okay, so if you were the little egg, we're gonna hatch after I say each number, okay? So curl into a little tiny egg. Oh, and out comes egg number 1. Hatch! Show me how you hatch with your arms up. And go back to your egg. And then egg number 2. Hatch! And come down. And egg number 3. Hatch! And come back to your egg. And egg number 4. Hatch! And come back down. And egg number 5. Hatch! And then come back down. Uh-oh, guess what? Egg number 6 doesn't hatch. And Mama Duck, she scratches her head like this. She's wondering, why isn't egg number 6 hatching? And the little brothers and sister ducklings are all waddling around the barnyard. And Mama Duck is just sitting there. And she is waiting and waiting and waiting. And that last little duck thing is not hatching. And she looks around at her babies, and this is what all of her babies look like. They are so cute, look. They are little baby ducklings, and they are yellow, and they have soft feathers. And do you see the orange duck bill? They're making their own sounds. Quack, quack, quack. Show me your duck bill. Quack, 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 quack. Quack, 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 quack. Well, just then, along comes a chicken. Can you show me how you would be if you were a chicken? And the chicken comes over like this, little chicken wings, and says, Mama Duck, why aren't you teaching your babies how to swim in the pond? And the mama says, well, I know I should be teaching my babies how to swim, but I have one last egg and it hasn't hatched yet. And just then the egg started moving around. So go back to your egg. You're that last little egg and you're inside the egg. And you start feeling around on the inside of the egg. Feel around on the inside of the egg. And guess what? You have that little beak. Show me your beak. And you start poking at the egg. Come behind you, poke at the egg. And you start to crack the egg. So you decide to stick one of your little feet. And do you know what ducklings have for feet? They're webbed feet. So stick one little foot out. Stick a foot out. Uh-oh, bring it back in. You stick the other foot out. Uh-oh, bring it back in. Uh-oh, do ducklings have hands? No, they have wings. So stick out one little wing. And then stick out the other little wing. And then there's your feet. Ready? You're going to stand up and pop out of the egg. Ready? Pop! Good. So, you're standing there. You have your little wings. And the ducklings and the mama duck, they're all looking at you like this. And you're like, but guess what?
You don't look exactly like the other ducklings. Do you want to see what you look like? You look like this. Oh, so you kind of look like the other ones, but you're a different color, right? See how you look a little bit different? You have a beak, but you're a different color. You're kind of grayish, right? And so the other ducklings, they start looking at you kind of funny because you don't look exactly.
Hi, Charlie.
Do you think Mrs. Dean is frozen?
I think Miss Dina is froze.
No, we can't do it. Why is it in the room? Oh, yeah, we're muted. But why am I muted? I should be muted.
You want to be muted? Mm-hmm. I can be muted. I was just making silly faces at your friends.
But
like this. I know.
Actually, I don't want to be muted. This is Nina's room. We can't do ballet without this is Nina.
Hi.
Mabel, you're
gonna get pink hair later tonight.
Mabel.
See, but I know.
Mabel.
What?
Do you think Mrs. Dina's frozen? Yeah, I do too. Mabel, I'm gonna have pink hair. I know. But next time.
You are. She's gonna get pink hair. Ask her how.
How?
This is hair dye. And it's.
Oh boy, we can't wait to see it.
I dye my hair. Next time I dye my hair blue. I guess what, Maddie? I finally watched Descendants.
Yay.
So you know who the people are now.
Are you still swimming in the pond? I'm so sorry.
There she is. There she is.
I don't know what happened.
You froze.
All right.
Out of the meeting.
Uh-oh. All right. Well, we were swimming in our pond. I don't know what happened. My internet connection kicked us all off. Just kicked me off. Sorry. Finish our story. Dad? All right. We were kind of close to the end. So it looks like I lost. Who did I lose? Let's see. Oh, there's a map. There's Ab.
I lost.
Okay. All right. So guess what happened? When you went to the pond, you were such a good swimmer. So you were swimming all around the pond. Show me how you swim. Oh, here's my music. Show me how you swim. Swim, swim, swim. Are you swimming? Oh my goodness, you're the best swimmer out of all the ducklings. You can even do the backstroke. Woo! That's true. Okay, and then guess what? Those other ducklings, they were not very nice. They saw that you were a better swimmer even, and so they were being kind of mean to you. And they were being kind of mean. So guess what? You swam away from them. You swam all the way away, and you hid in the tall grass. So put your hands up in front of your face. You're hiding in the tall grass because they were not being very nice to you. And it's not your fault that you look a little bit different. So peek out of the tall grass, look around. Oh no, there they are, hide again. And so you swim further away. You swim further and further and further away. Oh good, Harley's hiding behind the chair. Is that your tall grass? And guess what? You stayed there for a really long time. And it started to snow, and it got so cold. Over, show me how cold you are. So cold. So you decided to stay behind that tall grass for a really long time. And one day, the sunshine came out. Show me the sunshine. Open those arms, and you felt all this warmth on your skin. You were so warm. And you decided to come out of the tall grass. Everybody stand up. Come out of the tall grass and look around. And there were some other really beautiful birds swimming on the pond. But they had these really long, beautiful feathers. Can you show me your long, beautiful feathers and wings? And when they danced and swam, well, when they swam, it looked like they were dancing. I have a pretty song for you.
And you watch those pretty birds, and they dance all around so gracefully. Show me how you would dance if you had those long, pretty wings. Oh, I see some beautiful dancing. Let's see, Charlie. Show me your beautiful wings, Madeline. With us.
I'm just an ugly duckling. And they said, no, you're not. Look at your reflection in the water. You look just like us. And this is what you look like. What is that? It's a beautiful swan. So you have long, beautiful feathers, and you're a beautiful swan. Show me how you would dance to the Swan Lake song. This is a famous ballet called Swan Lake. And the dancers that pretend that they're the swan, Odette, they have long, beautiful arms. Can you show me your long, beautiful arms? And then you realized that even though you looked a little bit different than your brothers and sisters, that was okay. So you went back to the farmyard. And when your brothers and sisters saw you, they were so surprised. Can you show me a surprised face? They're so surprised. And they looked at you and they realized that you're not a duckling at all. You're a beautiful swan. And they felt so bad that they were not very nice to you at the beginning. And you all still became one big happy family and lived happily ever after. Yay! Did you like the story? Good. Hey, let's finish with our pixie dust dance and then we'll do a big curtsy and we'll say goodbye. And I'll have another story for you next time. Maybe at the end you can tell me. So if you have any ideas of some stories that you love that we could act out. Okay, so back up in your space just a little bit. Let's just do our pixie dust dance. We'll pretend we are going to wake up Tinkerbell. So if you have a little animal or a little friend that you want to put out to sprinkle your pixie dust on, you can. I have little lamb. Okay, let's do our dance. I'll find our music here. All right, so go off to the side. It is time for us to finish. It's so fun to see your cute smiling faces. Let's do a beautiful curtsy
And on the count of three, we'll say thank you. Ready? Open your arms. Let's go to B plus. 1 foot behind. 1, 2, 3, curtsy. Thank you, girls. Give yourselves a hand. Yay. All right. Sorry about my technical difficulties.